Please get ready for a dictation of Exercise 77 from Dr. G. D. Bist's Legal Magazine, Volume 1. 5 seconds. Start. The reference court referred to the evidence showing that the plot covered by Exhibit P2 was across the road from the acquired lands and was therefore a neighboring property. Feeling aggrieved, the appellant housing board filed appeals. The landowners filed cross objections. The High Court, by impugned judgment, dismissed the appeals of the appellant and allowed the cross objections filed by the landowners and increased the compensation to rupees 4 lakh per acre. Instead of Exhibit P2 relied upon by the reference court, the High Court relied upon Exhibit P19, which related to another auction sale of a smaller plot measuring 150 square meter of the municipality for a price of rupees 24,000, which works out to a price of rupees 16,000 per square meter. On that basis, the High Court works out the market value per acre as rupees 6 lakhs. The High Court was of the view that the deduction or cut towards development factor should be only 33% instead of 53% adopted by the reference court. By deducting 33% from rupees 6 lakhs, it arrived at the market value as rupees 4 lakh per acre while awarding the compensation. Feeling aggrieved, the Housing Board filed these appeals by special leave. The appellants have put forth the following contentions. Exhibit P19 relied upon by the High Court did not relate to a neighboring land, whereas there was specific evidence that the plot covered by Exhibit P2 was in regard to a nearby land. Therefore, Exhibit P2 ought to have been preferred to Exhibit P19. Further, as Exhibit P19 related to a very small plot, it ought to have been ignored, and the transaction relating to the larger plot, Exhibit P2, should have been preferred. The High Court ought to have maintained the cut towards cost of development as 53% instead of applying a cut of 33%. Auction sales do not furnish a safe guide for determination of market value, and therefore the High Court and reference court ought not to be relied upon either Exhibit P19 or Exhibit P2, which relate to auction sales. We may deal with the last submission first. The standard of litigation, which have the effect of dampening the enthusiasm of bidders and making them cautious, thereby depressing the price. There is therefore every likelihood of auction price being either higher or lower than the real market price, depending upon the nature of sale. As a result, courts are wary of relying upon auction sale transactions when other regular traditional sale transactions are available while determining the market value of the acquired land. This court in Rajkumar versus Haryana State 2007 SCC 609 observed that the element of competition in auction sales makes them unsafe guides for determining the market value. But where an open auction sale is the only comparable sale transaction available, on account of proximity in situation and proximity in time to the acquired land, the court may have to, with caution, rely upon the price disclosed by such auction sales by providing an appropriate deduction or cut to offset the competitive hike in value. In this case, the reference court and High Court, after referring to the evidence relating to other sale transactions, found them to be inapplicable as they related to far away properties. Therefore, we are left with only the auction sale transactions. On the facts and circumstances, we are of the view that a deduction or cut of 20% in the auction price disclosed by the relied upon auction transaction towards the factor of competitive price hike would enable us to arrive at the fair market price. There is clear evidence that the plot sold under Exhibit P2 was very near to the acquired lands, whereas there is no such specific evidence in regard to the proximity of the plot sold under Exhibit P19, though that plot was also in the vicinity. Further, though both Exhibit P2 and P19 relate to developed plots, Exhibit P19 relates to a comparatively small plot of 150 square meter, whereas Exhibit P2 refers to a larger plot of 329 square meter. Having regard to the proximity of location and the size, we are of the view that the reference court was justified in relying upon the sale transaction under Exhibit P2, and the High Court was not justified in ignoring Exhibit P2 and relying upon the transaction under Exhibit P19. We may also note that the general rule that the highest of the comparable sales should be relied upon will not apply where the sale transactions relied upon are auction sales for the seasons mentioned in para above. There is yet another important reason for ignoring the said auction sale for determining the market value of the acquired lands. In Karnataka Power Transmission Corporation case, this court determined the compensation at rupees 4 lakh per acre. Stop.